guys, how are you? It's Danny. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. So it's been a few weeks, about a month, I'm sorry, about a month since the last time I was on, and the last time I was talking about my MC. We've been kind of still dealing with the after emotional effects of that, and now we're just trying to move on. I just finished an eight week intense home workout program. What I do home workout programs, and this was a brand new one that we were just launching, and it's available to the public in October. So I'm very, very excited. It really helped my mind kind of get back into things and get back into the swing of things, and I just feel great with the fact that I was able to just focus on lifting and focus on my cardio, focus on my food, and just focus on me. And I got everything that I wanted to get out of that. I wasn't looking for six pack abs. I wasn't looking for monstrous muscles. I was looking for to get a little bit of my size back, to get a little bit of my definition back, to slim my waist a little bit, and also to get my head out of the fog. And that's exactly what happened, and that's exactly what I was looking for. I wasn't, weight loss was not my thing. Inches were not my thing. I just wanted to get out of my funk and then just get a little bit of the shape that I wanted back, and I got that. So I'm very happy with that. And then we're going to do a second round in October with our group, and if you want to join, please message me below. I will tell you all the details, or connect with me on Facebook. That's danny.antello.5 on Facebook. So just reach out to me there, and then I will, we can get on that. But so outside of that, I've been connecting with my writer friends, my writer community, and just kind of getting my head back in the writing game, because having a miscarriage and everything that goes along with that, and trying to get back to work and doing, just trying to get your mind right. It's hard. It's really hard. So I've been drinking lots of coffee. And there's a lot of stuff that's going on. There's going on the sidelines, or behind the scenes, in between my last video and now, and I'll get to that later. But right now, I just wanted to show you what I'm doing. And I don't know if you can see this. I'm gonna lift up my computer. This is really bad. I don't know if you can see him right there. Yeah, that's my Brooklyn. My old man. So he spends time with me in the morning. Cara's still sleeping with Dave. And this is what would have been the nursery. This is where I'm kind of working right now, because I need to be downstairs with him, because I don't want him walking up and down the stairs, and I'm not going to be lifting him up and down the stairs. To the main office. I may go back there during hunting season. I may go back there because it's a little bit more comfortable. The chair is more comfortable. This is just a wooden chair here, people. This ain't comfortable. So my back gets a little sore. I'm just like, it's too low and all that kind of stuff. But I get like the comfy kind of reclining black leather chair upstairs. So it's a little bit more comfortable. But for now, I can keep an eye on him. He doesn't have to strain. He just sleeps next to me, and then that way, if he needs to go to the bathroom, I can just kind of push him up there. My little man, he doesn't always have a lot of bowel movement controls. This may be TMI, but I'm a dog mom. This is what happens when you have an older dog. And so he may have a little accident. That's okay. Just clean it up. Once you're done with the toilet, it's all good. So I've been putting it together. Putting one of my scenes together, and I'm really trying to not edit as much as I need to, or as much as I think I need to be. But I'm rereading. This is my manuscript. So this is the original 451 pages, and so I have a working document, and then I have a pull from manuscript document. So like the actual manuscript, I'm actually taking chunks out of there and putting it into the working document, and I'm just putting it in chronological order, and because I'm cutting out a lot of things, but I want to keep the original just for my own sake. I want to keep the original there, and I'm having an original working document over here, and I'm kind of just working it that way. And there's a lot of things, but as I'm rereading it, I'm like, there's just some, just the way, now that I've learned a little bit as I've evolved as a writer, when I'm reading through it, I'm seeing like weedy words, I'm seeing a lot of adjectives, I'm seeing, just things that I'm like, this doesn't need to be there. I'm like, this doesn't move the story forward. I'm like, I don't think this character, I don't really like this character. She doesn't really have any value. This guy doesn't really have any value. I don't like this relationship anymore. So you know what? I'm going to just axe it, or just cut it off real quick. Just kind of speed things up a little bit so that the, I want the entire story to be whole and complete, obviously, but I don't need it to be big and bulky, and everything that I know about the characters and everything I know about the story doesn't need to be in the story. It just needs to, you know, I need to know that the reader needs to know that the writer knows everything, right? I need to know everything, but the reader doesn't need to know everything. So I need to be able to tie that in, like kind of bring the backstories in there, like get the feeling with the character, right? So that's what I've been working on, and I think I'm doing a pretty good job. I wanted to get everything out by September and October, but I don't think it's happening. I'm still pushing for 2018 release, but just with the last couple months, it's kind of really put a back seat to life and to priority. So now that it is a priority again, so and you know, that sounds really horrible. Of course my writing is a priority, my dog's a priority, my health is a priority, my writing is a priority, and I really don't want my work to, I want to work for my work. I don't want my work to work for me. Like, I don't want to put so much pressure on this body of work that it has to produce for me, okay? I need to show up for the story. So, my characters have done everything that I've asked them to do, and sometimes they do things I don't ask them to do, but, and the story goes in ways that I don't expect it to, but life never does. So, and this is my bad for not working with the proper outline, because the outline just wasn't working for me, and it just seemed really choppy and boring, and I'm just going to go by the seat of my pants. That's how life is. I'm just going by the seat of my pants, and I think that's also becoming a mistake. So I think I'm more of a plotter, where I plot it and I pants, so I kind of just write a couple things here, and then I just kind of keep writing. So it's becoming, I'm putting a little bit too much pressure on myself and the work, and I think that's unfair. That's what I've been talking with my community about, and I just need to get it done. It's already been done. It's already been written. I just need to finish the freaking second and third drafts. Like, it's just, come on. It doesn't take that. Like, I'm just putting too much pressure on it, and I can't do that. So, that is what I'm working on. I've got, like, copies and edits. I don't know if you can see that. Like, there's just edits all over these pages. Right, and then like some of these edits are from my editor in Connecticut from the writing program. So this has been going on a while, and I'm looking at her notes and I'm like, oh yeah, that doesn't make sense. Oh yeah, like that shouldn't be in there. Oh yeah, I don't need a new conflict here. Like, hello. So yeah, and then there was like a 26 page gap between, like, I had an event happen, and then I had, like, I've read it, or like I looked at the page numbers, like 26 pages later there's a resolution of something, and I was like, oh, that's way too soon. That is way too soon. So I had to bring that together. So yeah, and I think the I'm breaking down the chapters by scenes and not by life event. So I've got a little bit of work to do, but I think I've got a pretty good handle on things. So I'm excited to get this out there, because I really owe it to whatever happens to get out on the shelves, or at least get out on Amazon and create space. And I want to get it out there. I owe it to them. I owe it to myself. I just want to have a completed body of work that has the title with my name on it, and the picture, and the front back cover, and pages in between with words and sentences that I wrote, putting strings of words together and forming into sentences just means amazing things. And I will probably cry a shit ton of tears, and I will be shaking and have goosebumps and drink a lot of champagne and be very, very excited to get that out there, because I owe it. My friends have been waiting, my family have been waiting, I have been waiting, my characters have been waiting, I'm pretty sure my dogs have been waiting, because they're like, yo mom, you spent a lot of time in here, let's go. I get really distracted easily, so I really need to just focus and get this out there, because I do have other projects that I want to get going to, and I really want to be able to say that, you know, I have 5 to 7 books out there, right? Like, I just want to be able to say that, and I want to do this full time, I want to write full time. I want to create worlds full time. I'm done with the corporate world. I want to do this full time. I want to be a health and fitness coach full time. I want to be a mom full time. Like, I want to be a wife full time. I want to do those things full time. I do not want to work for someone else. I do not want to, increase someone else's pockets. Hello. Like, no. This life, my life is about me. It's not about making someone else rich, okay? I want to make my money, live modestly and happily and on my terms. So, I really want to get this out there, and I really want to get my fitness business working, and I really just want to do this for me and set that goal for me and get it done, because I owe it to myself and I owe it to this world to complete it. So this is what I'm working on. Make sure I have a lot of water. Stay really hydrated. I broke my water bottle earlier and a couple days ago, so I can fill the water bottle, and it sounds so pathetic, but it's just my chibi mindset one. It's like this tall and like exploded out of the bottom. It's got a straw in it. It was just lovely. It was lovely. But life happens. I'm just gonna order another one. That's right. Okay. So I'm gonna finish. I'm gonna have some more coffee. I'm gonna do a little bit more writing before Dave gets up, and have some breakfast because my stomach is growling. And then I will do a video of what has been going on between the last video and today. So thank you guys for joining in. I just wanted to give you a little bit of an update. If you have any questions about anything, please let me know. If you haven't hit subscribe yet, hit subscribe. And I will talk to you guys later. Okay. Mwah.